Hi everyone, welcome back to Coding Tricks. So in this session we are going to learn about CSS3. So why we are learning CSS3, introduction and what are the concepts in CSS3, we will learn and some more concepts. So why CSS3? CSS3 is the latest and current standards of CSS. It is completely backwards compatible with earlier versions of CSS like CSS2 and normal CSS. So, what are the modules which we are learning in CSS3, which is the extended or amend part of CSS2 is colors, selectors, style attributes, box models, backgrounds and borders, rounded corners, image values and replaced content, text effects, 2D, 3D transformations, transitions, animations, media queries, flexible boxes, multiple column layout, user interface. So these are all the concepts which came in CSS3. So now let us see that. First we will go for rounded corners. So what does this rounded corners mean? It will come as like if we want the curves in the corners. So what we will do? In that situation, we will write like this. So here I have given PID equal to R corners 1. Like this, I have given 4 corners. So let us see now 3. This is the other story. So 3 parts we will see. So here I have given border radius and 4 values. So what are those 4 values? Is the first value. Those 4 values are the curves which you want for the 4 corners. How much curve you want, you will give that much value over there. So, what is those values represent is, if you are giving here only 1 value, then it will affect to the 4 corners. If you are giving 2 values only, then it will affect to the top left and bottom right corners. The first value and the second value will affect to top right and bottom left corners. So the both values, if you are giving 2 values, it will affect like that. If you are giving 3 values, then it will affect the top right and bottom left corners and also bottom right corner. If you are giving 4 values individually like this, then it will affect to the 4 corners. So let us see how it will work. So here first one I have given 4 values, 15, 50, 35 PS I have given, and I have given background color, padding is for space, width, height, and I have given all this. For the second one, that means second, for the second or immediate corner one, what I have given here is, I have given 3 values, here I have given 2 values. So you can understand the story, right? Now I want to show you one with 1 value also. So here I will give R corners 4 with 1 value only. So if you are giving with 1 value, then it will affect to all the corners, right? Okay, let me take this person. I'm going to cut this because okay, let me do it as 5. Okay, then let us see now the output. So you can see the output over here. See how beautiful it is. So first corner is I have given for 4 values. I have given 4 values, right? You can see 4 corners like this. 4 corners, it is curved. Then for the second value, for the second one, I have given 3 corner values. So it is taking 3 corners. Then for the next one, I have given 2 values. So if it is 2 values, it will take for this. Right? So we have learned just now, right? If you are giving 2 values, then it will affect to top left and bottom right corners. And second value is top right and bottom left. If you are giving 3 values, then it will affect to top left corner for the first value. And the second value is top right and bottom left. And the third value is bottom right corner. So here I have given 1 value. So it will affect to all the four. So this is how the rounded corners, sorry, the corners you can write. If we want the elliptical one, so what we will do? In that situation, if we want the elliptical corners, so I will show you. So here it is. So the elliptical corners have given 30px by 60%. That means first thing will occupy 30px and the next one will occupy 60% whatever you have. So let me see. So this is how it will come. You can observe here 30px and 60%, right? So this is how the elliptical corners will come. So for the image, now I am going to show you the beautiful concept image. So if you want the image as in circle model, if you want the image in circular model, then what you will do? So let me show you. Here I have written already the code. Just image border radius we will give it as 50%. And one more thing also I will show you. How you can also give in this way also, like I will show you. I am going to copy this. So here I have given two things now. So PID equal to or corner 5 for this one. What I am going to show you is, sorry, deep coding tricks. For this I can write like this also. Border top left radius, border top right radius, border right. So in this way also I can give. That means I can specify which border length, like which border I want. Top left or top right or bottom left, which border, how much border I want, I can specify here. And the next one is, here I will have given image. Image I have given border radius is 50%, which I want it as circle border. So you can see the outputs here. So see here. These are the two things. Here I have given border top left radius with 50, right with 20, border top right, bottom left, and for the image I have given border radius is 50%. See, if I have given 60%, what will happen, or 70%? If I want it in circle manner, so I should give 50%. Big circle. So, it is not exactly circle, right? So in this way it will come. So you can change the values over here also if you want. So this is how the rounded corners concept came in CSS3. So we cannot do this in CSS2. We cannot make the images beautiful like this, right? So with the help of CSS3 we can do whatever we want. So this is very, very helpful when we are developing the web pages. And when we are developing any WordPress themes or any themes like that. So we can do whatever we want. Some more concept we will see in the next session. I hope you enjoyed this video, right? Yes. So thank you everyone. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you. Bye bye.